This is a wheeled self-balancing robot. Powered by Arduino UNO and balanced by ultrasonic sensor. It is able to balance itself vertically. Let's see how it's made and how it works. This is the CAD design of the wheeled self-balancing robot. Here we can see two motors connected with two wheels. These motors are mounted in the PVC T-joint. A vertical PVC pipe is attached to T-joint. An ultrasonic sensor is attached to the pipe, pointing downwards. Now let's make this robot as per the CAD design. We will be using two geared DC motors to power this robot. Hey, where are you going? Stop here. Now we will attach wheels to the shaft of the motor. This is a T-joint for PVC pipe. We will be using it to hold the motors. Like this. The wires will come out from the top hole. Before fixing the motor in this pipe, we have to wire them. We will be passing four wires from the top hole. Splitting at two ends, two wires for each motor. Now, we will be connecting these wires to the motors. The red wire will be connected to the red mark terminal. And the black wire will be connected to the white mark terminal. The same procedure needs to be followed for the second motor. Both the motors are wired and ready. We will pull the wire back from T-joint so that the motors will be in its place. Now we have fixed the motor in the T-joint with the help of some rubber and adhesive. They are secured, nice and tight. We have added some pipes at the wire end of the T-joint. We will mount a sensor on it later. Here is the circuit schematic. We have used L293D H bridge motor driver IC to rotate motors in both directions. According to this schematic, we will connect all the components. But, we will connect the sensor later. Now, we will test it. Left forward, right reverse. Right forward, left reverse. Both forward, both reverse. Now, we can also play with it as an RC car. We are controlling it through the computer. And commands are sent serially to the microcontroller. The concept for this self-balancing robot is simple. Here we have an ultrasonic sensor, which measures its distance from the obstacle in front of it. If the distance is greater than the fixed distance, then the robot will move forward, and if the distance is less, then the robot will move reverse to compensate for its fall. Now, it's time to connect the ultrasonic sensor, which will help it to keep balanced. The ultrasonic sensor has four pins, which are trigger, echo, power, and ground. Four wires are connected from the pins to microcontroller. We have written the logic and the code and uploaded it to the microcontroller. So, what it does is, it moves the robot forward if the distance is greater than a fixed value. This means, the robot is falling forward, so move forward to keep it balanced. And vice versa. Now, the robot is placed vertically on the ground. And it seems like, it is balanced. It is moving continuously to keep itself balanced. But, it is also getting some support from the wires, which I am holding in my hand. It is oscillating back and forth continuously. These oscillations need to be damped. So, the robot will be balanced and stand at a point without any movement. But we haven't used PID control. We have just said to move back if falling back and move forward if falling forward. It seems like it is able to balance. But, if it falls beyond a particular point, then it won't be able to recover itself. These motors require a lot more power to be fast and responsive. And while testing, the second H bridge of the L293D got fried. So, I didn't get the chance to control it via PID. To truly make it balanced, we could have used the MPU-6050, the inertial measurement unit. Instead, we used this cheap ultrasonic sensor. But, somehow we managed to make it balanced a little bit. We are happy with the results. That's all for now. See you again with more robotic technologies. Robotics everywhere.